What's going on, everyone? It is Brad, or Demon Asylum here. I'm bringing you all a new Fallout 4 video. I'm going to be showing you all that after the patch has now come out for all systems, the infinite XP glitch with making statues, which is the best one we had, as well as the workshop resource duplication glitch, both still work to the fullest. First of all, I want to show you guys that I am connected to Xbox Live. There's my friends list, for instance. I'm also going to go into my settings and show you that it's the same date I'm posting this video and after the time the patch has come out for all systems. Wednesday, December 9th, 2015, 9:58 a.m. and Eastern Time Zone, as that is the time zone that I live in. Now that we have that out of the way, let's go ahead and start into a basic rundown of the glitch. I'm not going to go into full detail, such as I'm not going to show where to get the Picket Fences magazine to create statues, or rather to unlock statues. If you need to know any more information about the glitches than I provide in this video, check out my original video on the glitches. I'll put an annotation on the screen and the link in the description. So you want to have your workshop completely cleared out of any junk whatsoever. Also, you want to have your inventory cleared out of any junk except for the shipment of resources you want to duplicate. We're making statues, so of course we need copper. I bought one shipment of copper from a vendor, and I used the dogmeat duplication glitch, which also still works after patch, to make 7 more. Now, once you have your workshop and your inventory clear of any junk except for your shipment in your inventory, you're going to want to go ahead and hit the button to store all junk, which on Xbox is Y and on PlayStation is triangle. And then right after that, you want to hit the button to take all, which is X on Xbox and square on PlayStation. So let's go ahead and do this. Alright, so I just did it 4 times, I believe it was, and we'll take that copper out. And I'll show you guys here that we now have 1,000 copper, and we also still have our 8 shipments. So, there's proof that the resources duplication glitch with the workshop still works. Let me go ahead and put my shipments away so I don't accidentally use them. If you run out of example for this 1,000 copper when making statues, then it will go into your shipments. So you don't want to have that happen, because then you can't do the duplication glitch with the workshop anymore. Now that you have your materials, or your resources rather, to create statues or whatever it is you want to do this glitch with, you want to make sure your settlement's maxed out to the point where you can only make one more item. So as you guys can see, I can only make one statue. I can't build anything else. That's the way you want to have it. So now once you have it like that, what you want to do is spam just 2 buttons. One of the buttons is going to be what you press to actually create the statue, and the other button is going to be what you do to scrap it. So on Xbox One, that's going to be A and then X. And on PlayStation, it's going to be X and then square. So let's go ahead and get a demonstration here for you guys of spamming these 2 buttons to get the mass amounts of XP. Oh, I'm sorry, I need to be actually highlighting it. There we go. My apologies, of course, for the button spamming. You can probably hear it. My Blue Yeti does pick up quite a bit. But you guys get the idea. You know, I don't want to stay here forever. You guys get the idea that you just sit here and you spam literally 2 buttons as long as you have everything set up properly with your settlement, and then you will just get mass amounts of XP just like you did before the patch ever came out. So that's really all I wanted to show you guys though. If you guys have any questions, as usual, you can post them in the comment section and I will be sure to reply to you, help in any way that I can. I'm going to continue to put out all of these videos of glitches showing you guys what didn't get patched, also showing you maybe some new variations of ones that did get patched, such as the vendor caps glitch if I figure something out. And then I have some new glitches in the works as well that I was just waiting for the patch to come out to see if they actually did anything to. But that's going to be about it for this video. I do hope you all have enjoyed or found it helpful. If so, feel free to drop a like on the video down below and subscribe for many more Fallout 4 videos to come. Thanks for watching, everyone, and peace out.